Now I can try to install Sony Vegas, because last time it complained I wasn't using at least XP Service Pack 3 or Vista or Windows 7. So let's see what happens. Of course, this is far below its minimum requirements, but see if it installs. Of course, there's no way in hell this is going to be playing or editing HD video, but I'll see if it at least tries to work with standard definition video. I guess we'll see how that works out. And yeah, I've been staying up late trying to get this finished, so just try to get this installed and I'll call it a night. Well, believe it or not, I got Sony Vegas working on this old Compaq Pentium 3. I was able to take a test video, drag it into the timeline. Now it's rendering it to a MPEG-2 file. It's about a 2-minute video, and it's saying approximate time left 18 minutes, and it's 8% done, so maybe 20 minutes total rendering time. So obviously not the fastest thing in the world. You can see the preview there going through the frames. And I can kind of hear the fan speed kicking up as the processor is pretty much maxed out right now. So, I'll keep tabs on how long it actually takes. See, there's an elapsed time and its best guess of how long it's going to take, which has actually gone down since I just started talking about it. That fan speeding up, so I'll let it do its thing and show you the results. Well, there it finished. It took just under 17 minutes to render right about 2 minutes of test video in DV widescreen format, rendering it to an MPEG-2 file. I think 6 megabit for video and 224 kilobit audio. It doesn't give you options to set the bitrate yourself, at least not in the free trial version, so that was my only real option there that I could use. It also did deinterlacing. I used the blend fields method, which gives you a better resolution at the expense of some blurring of the motion, but for the kind of videos I do, I'm not constantly moving around and looking at different things, so that's why the blend fields method works better for my videos, because if I'm just like pointing at something here and demonstrating something, then it gives you better quality with less of the jagged edges on diagonal lines. So there's Sony Vegas running on the old Compaq, and as well as Service Pack 3, which was required to let me install Vegas. Obviously this will not be a main video editing computer, but just wanted to kind of prove to myself that it could be done even on this over 10-year-old computer. So, don't necessarily need a brand new machine to edit videos. If you have a little patience, it can be done on even a rather old machine that most people would have thrown out by now. First, the USS and now I'm right on time to record an hour-long radio show from WNYC, where after the news finishes here. So I just have this tuner hooked up to the line input. This little cable here, it's supposed to be for a subwoofer, but I just use it as a level control. It's a lot easier than trying to go through the Windows mixer, especially since some very loud sources will clip the input even before it gets to the mixer. So to prevent the clipping, I control the level before it goes into the sound card. So that works just fine. If they're not completely sure a melon is safe, they should throw it out. In a minute here, I'm going to start recording.
She came for our opera stage, but she took over our newspapers, buses, and taxis too. This is Soundcheck. I'm John Schaefer, and today on the show, Anna Netrebko. She's the featured voice and the ubiquitous face of the new season at the Metropolitan Opera. We also have a review of the ballet going on next door by a rising young composer named Paul McCartney, and a live performance by the chart-topping band Foster the People. I know, quite a lineup today. Elb, who runs the Metropolitan Opera, he took over in 2004 and almost immediately started trying to convince you to really focus in on the Met. How hard did he have to work to convince you?
That's what he said.
That's what he says.
I know this opera very well, and I've done it many times before. It was just a different theater, and I tried to think so.
Here's the end result of the hour-long audio recording using Adobe Audition. As you can see, the audio is already highly compressed from the radio station, but WNYC is actually one of the least processed stations in New York City, so this is nothing comparing to how extreme the processing is on the commercial music stations. So this Compaq does just fine with audio recording using its Aureal Vortex 2 sound card and Adobe Audition running in Windows XP.